Welcome students to our English class. Today we are going to understand a lesson, The Work of a Fabric. What do you understand by looking at these pictures? They all look like the devotees of God. Yes, they all are saints. The word saint comes from the Latin word sanctus, which means holy. Saints are the people who believe in God and follow His teachings and guide people with the God's teachings. These people are also saints. Saint Kabir, Guru Nanak, Saint Eknath, Saint Mirabai, Saint Tukaram, and Saint Thiruvalluvar. Their teachings are also as same as God's teachings, such as equality, brotherhood, honesty, kindness, politeness, etc. So today we are going to understand about a similar saint who lived his life with similar teachings. The name of the story is The Worth of a Fabric, where the wise saint was approached by an arrogant young man. We are going to start the story with the first line. Thiruvalluvar was a great till the fabric was reduced to rags. The name of the saint was Thiruvalluvar. Thiruvalluvar was a Tamil saint. He used to write poems about the teachings of God. He lived in Mayilapur, which is in Chennai, Tamil Nadu, in India. According to the sources, he lived in the 1st century BC or 6th century BC, which is 2000 years ago. Many of his ideas were revolutionary. Revolutionary means something which has brought major change. He dismissed caste system. According to him, no one was small or no one was big. Everyone was equal. He wrote the book Thirukkural. Thirukkural is the book of his teachings. Thirukkural is greatly loved and respected even today. It has great influence on Tamil culture and life. It has been compared to all the holy books of the world's major religions. Thirukkural has 133 sections of 10 couplets each. Couplets means two lines which have rhyming words. It is also called as verses. Thirukkural is divided into three books. Here we have some sayings of Thiruvalluvar from Thirukkural. Even if someone does something that brings bad to you, do something good for them and make them feel shy for what they have done to you. Here, Thiruvalluvar wants to tell us that if someone has done something bad to you, you should do something good to that person and make that person feel shy about what he has done with you, so that the person can never do this to you or anyone again. Here there is another saying from Thirukkural. It is foolish to think that the clothes can hide your indecency. If you have a bigger flaw, which is bad character. Here Thiruvalluvar is saying us that the clothes cannot hide a person's indecency or bad character. So it is foolish if you think that wearing good clothes will hide your indecency or bad character. Here there is another saying from Thirukkural. There is no greater wealth than virtue, and no greater loss than to forget it. Virtue means goodness. So here Thiruvalluvar is telling us that no money is greater if you have good virtue in yourself. Virtue is your wealth, your goodness, your kindness is your wealth. And if you lose it or forget it, then you are in a big loss, you are in a great loss. Thiruvalluvar was a textile weaver. He wove beautiful fabrics and saris and sold them in the market. People said that he never got angry, never used bad words, or never shouted at anyone. Textile weaver is a person who weaves clothes or stitches clothes. So Thiruvalluvar was also a textile weaver. And after weaving the clothes, he used to sell them in the market. His clothes were very beautiful. People also said something about him that he never got angry on anyone. He never shouted at anyone or never used bad words for anyone. He was very calm, wise, very kind person. In the same town, there lived a rich young man. He wasted most of his time roaming around with his friends. They often made fun of other people. "I don't believe what people say about this Valluvar," said the young man one day. "I'm sure I can make him angry. Come on, let's have some fun today." Roaming around means moving around without any reason, especially in a wide area such as market. So where Thiruvalluvar lived, in the same town, there lived a rich young man. He was very rich, and he used to waste most of his time roaming around with his friends, and all of them used to make fun of other people. He got to know about Thiruvalluvar, that Thiruvalluvar is a very calm person. So he said to his friend that he don't believe about whatever people say about Valluvar. And he said to his friend that he was sure that he would make Thiruvalluvar angry and wanted to make fun of Thiruvalluvar. So the arrogant young man approached Thiruvalluvar in the market and picked up a beautiful piece of fabric. "How much does this whole fabric cost?" he asked. 8 coins. The saint named the price. The young man unfolded the fabric and tore into two. "What's the price of this piece now?" Arrogant means unpleasantly proud and behaving as if he is more important than other people. Fabric means a piece of cloth. Unfolded means opening a folded piece. So here, this arrogant young man went to Thiruvalluvar, approached means went to Thiruvalluvar in the market and picked up a beautiful piece of fabric. He asked Thiruvalluvar the price of the fabric, and Thiruvalluvar politely answered him 8 coins. Then, for making Thiruvalluvar angry, the young man unfolded the fabric and tore it into two parts. and then asked, "What is the price of this piece now?" "4 coins," the saint answered politely. The youth was taken aback. "Why doesn't the man get angry?" he thought. He then tore the half pieces into half again. "And now, 2 coins," was the answer. Taken aback means surprise or shock. So, when the rich young man, torn the piece into half, he asked the price to Thiruvalluvar. Thiruvalluvar answered the rich young man politely, 4 coins, without getting angry. Looking at this calmness of Thiruvalluvar, this man was taken aback. That means he was surprised, he was shocked. That why don't this man get angry? Then for making him angry, he tore the half piece into half again. And he again asked the price to Thiruvalluvar. Again Thiruvalluvar answered him politely, 2 coins. Now, it was the young man who became impatient and agitated. He tore the pieces into half again and again, saying, "And now, what is the price now?" Thiruvalluvar calmly went on reducing the price to half every time. At last, the fabric was reduced to rags. Impatient means restless. Agitated means feeling or appearing disturbed. Rags means a piece of old cloth torn from a large piece used for cleaning things. So when Thiruvalluvar reduced the price to 2 coins, this young man became restless. He became impatient and he was feeling disturbed. And for making Thiruvalluvar angry, he was tearing the cloth again and again into half. And he kept asking, "What is the price now?" And calmly Thiruvalluvar went on reducing the price to half every time. At last, the fabric, which was torn many times, was reduced to rags. So now, we will move on to the question answers of this lesson. First question is, make sentences from following words. Here I have listed down few words. You have to make sentences from these words. I have given one example as well from the first word, viewer. The viewer gave me a beautiful piece of cloth. Here, I have used the word viewer in a sentence. Similarly, you will also have to use the words in a sentence. Question number 2. Answer the following questions in one sentence. Who was Thiruvalluvar? Thiruvalluvar was a textile viewer and a Tamil saint poet. What is Thiruvalluvar's book of teachings called? Thiruvalluvar's book of teachings is called Thirukkural. Who made fun of other people? A rich young man and his friend often made fun of other people. What did the rich young man wanted to do? The rich young man wanted to make Thiruvalluvar angry. Question number 3. Describe the following with the help of the story. First one is Thiruvalluvar. Thiruvalluvar was a great Tamil saint poet who lived more than 2000 years ago. Thirukkural is his book of teachings. It is greatly loved and respected even today. Thiruvalluvar was a textile weaver who wove beautiful fabrics and saris and sold them in the market. He never got angry, never used bad words, and never shouted at anyone. Second is the rich young man. The rich young man was arrogant and proud of his riches. He wasted most of his time roaming around with his friends. He often made fun of other people. Question number 4. Write synonyms for the given words. Here, I have given one example of synonym. Synonym means two similar words. So the first word is arrogant. Arrogant also means self-importance or full of oneself. There are two more words, textile and shouted. You have to write down the synonyms for these two words. Question number 5. Write antonyms for the given words. Antonyms means opposites. The first word is agitated. Agitated means disturbed. The opposite word for agitated are calmed and relaxed. Here are two more words, impatient and roaming. You have to find out antonyms for these two words. Question number 6. Identify parts of speech of the highlighted words. Here I have given one example for the first sentence. He wove beautiful fabrics, saris and sold them in the market. Here the highlighted words are wove, beautiful and market. So I have written parts of speech of these words. Wove is a verb. Beautiful is an adjective. Market is a noun. The second sentence is, in the same town there lived a rich young man. Here, in, town and rich are the highlighted words. You have to write the parts of speech for these three words. So the arrogant man approached Thiruvalluvar one day. In this sentence, arrogant man approached are the three words which are highlighted. Thiruvalluvar calmly went on reducing the price. Here, Thiruvalluvar calmly went are the three highlighted words for which you have to write the parts of speech. Thank you, students. Now, we will meet in the part 2 of this lesson.